Out in the shack with the blue tick hound, broke as hell, but blessed with beauty, the kind that a rich man can't turn down. She caught the eye of an oil man dancing one summer night in a dime store dress. She had the looks.
Die? I didn't thought you died there. You think I did the magic spell then? How did I do this? You just show up out of nowhere. But now that you die are here, I got a video for you, Die. It's gonna be for this weekend. It's gonna be the next episode of Talent for Proposition with Adventurous Thomas. So before we get into the video of who's gonna win and who's gonna lose this weekend, let's talk a little bit about the testicles. Like, if you have not done it already, hit that subscribe button down below, turn it from red to gray, make sure the bell notification on so you get notified when I post, give the video a big thumb up right away. Before you even did into the video, you said that dancing was pretty cool, right? You gotta admit, that dancing was pretty cool. And leave a comment below if you like some music, if you like to dance, if you like to sing, or when you're thriving, you like to like have a little like sing along and just dance around when you're thriving, like blast your music, because that's definitely me. Alright, enough of all that. Also, comment below, who do you think is gonna have an upset weekend, or an easy weekend to just to win, to lose? In football, what do you guys think? So I will let you guys know mine right here. Alright, the first game is actually tomorrow night, Friday night, 9 o'clock. It's between New Mexico and Boise State. Okay. I hate to say it. There is a clear answer on who's gonna win. New Mexico is not playing very good football this season. Their average is just not playing, like, I don't know, they're not doing good. So, Boise State is going to take the W on Friday night to start off the college football weekend. And left it on to Saturday, starting with my team. I is 10-0, but this week the opponent is not that good. So, they're going to be 11-0. Automatically, without a doubt, this game, Alabama can pretend it's a scrimmage, they can pretend it's a practice, because they're gonna take the W either way, because they don't have to play hard for this one. The team that they're playing is just not down at the bottom of the list. Like the Titel, well, I don't even know that team. And they only won four games and they lost this. So they're gonna add four. They're gonna be 4-7, and Alabama's gonna be 11-0. Let's go, Alabama! Roll Tide! All right. The next one is Florida versus Iowa. All right. Again, I would tell you that Florida is really good at football, especially in college. They're not as good in football in the NFL, the pro, but they're definitely good in football in college. But not as better than Alabama. It's there. But this week, Florida's gonna beat Iowa. It's an easy clear answer from all the stats, from all the How they been playing all year. Florida gonna pull out with the W. The next one in Mid-Tennessee versus Kentucky. This one is gonna be a great game to pay attention to. It's gonna be a great game to stay tuned, to tune in. This is gonna be a ball game. There's not a clear answer on who's gonna win and who's gonna lose. This could come down to the last second. The very last second. This could be a clear winner. But it could go into overtime. Could go into another overtime. It could stay that tie. Who knows? I'm telling this game is gonna be a ball game. This is gonna be a ball game, boys and girls. Alright, the next one is Arkansas and Mississippi State. Now, for me, Arkansas is that football team that is like just almost good enough, but not clearly. So I'm gonna, and Mississippi State is a good football team. Like, they have a solid defense. So then they're playing Arkansas. I'm thinking Mississippi State is gonna win. But not by much. Maybe by 10 points is their lead for the whole game. They might have a more lead than that, but I'm thinking a 10 point game. Alright, the next one. This might be an easy game for Penn State. Just like Alabama versus the Titel. But they're playing Rudel. They're not that good if you compare them to Penn State. So I'm thinking Penn State is gonna have an easy win, maybe even a blowout. But they're gonna move on and do 8-3. Alright, the next one is Maryland versus Ohio State. Maryland is an average team. They only won 5 games. They're not playing as well as they normally. They're not a good football program. Like, they're decent. They're not good to, like, the standard. So, with that being said, and they're playing a top football team, top football franchise, I'm gonna say Ohio State, that's just a W out of this week. They're gonna just take home the W. The next one is Northwestern and Minnesota. This one could be another good game. This one could be a good game. That being said, there could be a clear winner, but there also can be a good game where it can be like tied, or it can be so close that you have to watch the whole game to find out who wins. But as of right now, and what both of these teams have done, I'm saying Northwestern is gonna take home the W. Just as by how they've been playing. The next one is Utah and Colorado. Now this one, there's a lot of teams this week that have a higher percentage of winning over the other opponent that they're playing. It's that a lot of teams are playing like kind of like the average low team when they're up way high. But this is another game. Utah is playing pretty damn good football this year than Colorado. So I'm gonna say Utah is gonna take another W to make themselves 8-3 by the end of the weekend. And the next thing we got is Utah State and Colorado State. Again, this is pretty much the same thing we talked about before. They're both in the same state, just different colleges. Utah State, again, is doing better than Colorado State. This season, they're playing good football. So I'm taking Utah State to take another W to make their Western 10-1. Alright, this next game is probably the game of the week. It is LSU from upstate New York and Notre Dame. Notre Dame is undefeated, just like Alabama, 10-0. LSU is 8-3. 8-2, my bad, 8-2. So, with that being said, if LSU come out and play like they have the last 2 weeks, they could make an upset than Notre Dame. But personally, me, do I see that happening? Because of LSU, I do not see that happening. I see Notre Dame winning LSU and putting their record 11-0, just like Alabama. So, with that being said, Notre Dame's gonna win this week. And I'm pretty sure the Dame is in upstate New York, too. So, yeah, I'm still picking Notre Dame to win. Alright, the next one is FSU, which is Florida State University, and it's Boston College. This one, it might be a clear answer. Boston College gonna win this week, just by how they've been playing, and then all the team that they've been playing so far. Florida State University is kind of struggling right now. They're in the midst of the average, the low ranking team right now. They're not doing good. They did better in the past, but they're struggling to win. So I'm gonna say Boston College gonna win, and then Florida State University. So let's go on to the next game. The next game is West Virginia and Oklahoma State. Wow. Now, you can say this to be a ball game. It's a no either way. Or you can say West Virginia's gonna totally win of just how well they play. I kind of want a ball game because there's not too many ball games this week. There's like one ball game that is like gonna be a very good game. But not many. Most of them are gonna be like the opponent blowing out the other opponent. So this game, I kind of want another ball game because we need some more ball game because it'll be more fun to watch. But in the end, I think West Virginia dropped it in the book. I think they didn't pull off the W. Alright, the next one is University of Massachusetts and Georgia. This is, again, an easy, clear win on who's gonna win, unless University of Massachusetts come out of the locker room and just show up like that. Like, turn on their brain and just show up. But if they don't do that, it's an easy win, and I think Georgia's gonna take home the W to make their record 10-1. Alright, the next one is, again, another easy win for one of the opponents. It's Indiana versus Michigan. You all know who I'm gonna pick, even though it's not my team, but it's obvious. I think Michigan's gonna take the W and make their record 10-1. Alright, the next one we got is Oregon State and Washington. Alright, so this one to be a ball game, or to be one of those games where one of the opponents can come out and win, like automatically, with Friday take the W. I'm gonna go with Washington, Jefferson. They've been playing good, and last week they played really good. So I'm gonna pick Washington to win over Oregon State. The next one might be another big game. It's Duke versus Clemson. This could be a ball game. Clemson undefeated at 10-0. Duke is 7-3. Clemson always one of those top teams. They always managed to win every season. Duke is just almost there to win every season. But I think this might be a good ball game to watch. Clemson could lose this one. Or maybe they can just blow them out. I don't know, but I think this is a good ball game. Alright, this next one is why at LSU? Why 1-10? LSU is 8-2. Just by that, I think that tell you, like, and I personally, I never heard of White College. Where's White College? If anybody knows where White College is, leave that down below, because I have no idea. But according to their weather, it looks like they're not, they're not playing football that good. We're only winning one game out of the 10 or 11 they played. Yeah, the 11 they played. So I'm gonna pick LSU to win. Maybe LSU doesn't even blow them out. Who knows? But LSU is probably gonna take the W this week. The next one is Kansas and Oklahoma. Now, Oklahoma is the top team. And Kansas is not really a top team, but they're a top team in basketball. Kansas is a top team in basketball, but not football. But, so, just by looking at that, I'm going to pick Oklahoma to win. Because Oklahoma is doing a really good job at playing football this year. They got the game down. Like, they're solid. Like, they should definitely be in the playoff. And the next game we got is Texas and Iowa State. This is going to be a great game to watch. It's gonna be a close game. It's gonna be a tight game too. You don't know who's gonna win or lose. But if I had to pick someone to win, I might have to go with Texas. But I do want to find an upset, so I might have to change my answer from not Texas to Iowa State, because I want that upset. Because I think this is the week that Iowa State is gonna win and make Texas lose. So, I kind of want that upset. Let's see if Iowa State can do that. Alright, the next one. Oh, this one's gonna... This game is gonna be a slow game that boys can do. Cincinnati and UTF. One of them is 9-0, and the other one is 9-1. How slow of a game is that? That's a ball game. This game is gonna be a ball game. And just looking at the team and how well they've been playing all season, this is gonna be a great game to watch and pay attention to on Saturday at 8 o'clock. Right here, right now. It's unbelievable. And then the next one is Arizona and Washington State. Arizona 5-5, Washington State is 9-1. Arizona is kind of doing like the up and down, like every other week they win or lose, they're doing like stuff like that. Washington State is kind of staying pretty good, they only lost one. So this week, I think I had to go with Washington State, just because Arizona, their season right now is like up and down, win, lose, win, lose. So Washington State will win. Alright. So that's all the games that are going to be playing this weekend. I think there's a couple more. I think there's like two or three more. But I don't know who they are. But out of ESPN list, the top 25 teams, or one of the teams in each of these games are top 25. But just by looking at the... It looks like this weekend it's gonna be a blowout weekend. A lot of the team are playing like not so good teams. They're pretty much just having a practice or a scrimmage against them. They don't have to go extremely hard. There's maybe like two or three teams that are like they're gonna be ball games, like. We don't know who's gonna win or who's gonna take the ball. So either way, but like there were only like two or three games. The rest of them are like, you definitely didn't tell if they're gonna win. And you can definitely tell that they're just gonna have a practice with women than the team, because why would you play harder than like a team like that. So that's all that I have for the prediction of football. If you agree with what I said, leave it down below. If you have a different idea, leave that down below. I'd love to read them. And for now, don't forget to, if you haven't already done it at the beginning, or you haven't already done it, period, and this is your first video on my channel, hit that subscribe button, turn it from red to gray. Make sure you hit that bell notification next to it to get notified to when I post, because, well, within that time when I'm gonna be doing Vlogmas, which is vlog every day of December. So that's gonna be a fun time. There's lots of ideas that I'm gonna do entire all my videos that month. Like event, game, just vlogging my day, whatever it's gonna take. So you don't wanna miss any of that. And it's the holiday, so like you might can see like Christmas light and all that, so make sure you hit that bell notification to watch those. And then give this video a big thumb up right now. If you're excited about Christmas or excited about college football this week. And just remember to enjoy the little things in life. And don't take life for granted. Do not take life for granted. And we will see you guys in the next video. Bye! Bang up, 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 bang up